welcome you, boys and girls. Let us have a review of some questions. In silica, SiO2, what is coordination number of silica and oxygen? Silica is a three-dimensional network, which we know as SN, where every silicon is tetrahedrally bonded to four oxygens, and every oxygen is bonded to two silicons. It is a three-dimensional network. So you can clearly see that silicon coordination number surrounded by four oxygens, oxygen coordination number is 2. This is there in 14th group lesson called carbon silicon family about silicates. Try to recollect that. And now let us look at question number 2. In a typical crystal, A is given as 0.387 picometers, B is also 0.387 picometers. But C is given as axial length C, 504 picometers. If alpha is equal to beta is equal to 90 degrees and gamma is equal to 120 degrees, what type of crystal system it is? These parameters clearly indicate A is equal to B, not equal to C. Alpha is equal to beta 90 and gamma is 120. This data indicates it must be hexagonal HCP, hexagonal closed pack system. Should remember cubic system, tetragonal system, orthorhombic system, rhombohedral system, hexagonal, monoclinic, triclinic. You should remember all this. We can expect a question from them. Now we are looking at a third question. Our third question right now is, in each isolated FCC, phase center cubic unit cell of NaCl, how many ions are there? Never the unit cells are isolated, but this is a hypothetical question. If you isolate a unit cell, there will be as many ions, as many positions occupied. The positions occupied in the system can be the corners. You can have, say, Na plus. Then if it is there in corner, it will be also there in phase center. Therefore, there are total 6 phase centers, and there are total 8 corners. So 6 plus 8 is 14 Na plus should be there. Then your Cl minus will be there in edge center, also in body center. Edge centers are 12 and body center is 1. Body center 1. So total 13. So if there are 14 Na plus, there will be 13 Cl minus. Or else in isolated unit cell, if there are 14 Cl minus, there will be 13 Na plus. So total electrical neutrality is never balanced if it is isolated. But electrical neutrality is balanced if and only if the unit cells are never isolated, they exist in three-dimensional array. If it is a three-dimensional array, on an average, each unit cell will have 4 Na plus and 4 Cl minus. It is average. It is a hypothetical question. Now let us look at another problem. This problem is asking you, if in a FCC unit cell, edge length is equal to 200 picometers and 200 grams of this material has 24 into 10 to the power 23 atoms, what is its density? To know density, our formula is density is equal to number of particles present in given type of system into atomic mass by Avogadro number into A cube. Now, from the given data, Z is equal to 4 because it is FCC. Atomic weight. They gave the mass of 24 into 10 to the power 23 atoms as 200. Atomic mass is equal to mass of 6 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. If 24 into 10 to the power 23 atoms are 200, 6 into 10 to the power 23 atoms would be 50. So atomic weight is 50. 4 into 50 by Avogadro number into A. A is given in picometers. Picometer into 10 to the power minus 10 is equal to centimeter. Whenever they ask you density, you better convert into centimeters, because atomic weight you are taking in grams per mole. So A cube. If you simplify, you will be getting the answer. Answer is like 41.66 grams per centimeter cube. A tricky problem. FCC Z is equal to 4. A, find out. N, you should remember Avogadro number. A, convert into centimeters by multiplying picometers with 10 to the power minus 10. Okay, last question. If you are saying that the sodium is crystallizing as PCC and magnesium is crystallizing as FCC, number of particles present in each unit cell. On an average, each unit cell of BCC will have 2 particles. FCC, on an average, each unit cell will have 4 particles. So answer is 2 and 4. This is a set of 5 review questions at the moment. Thank you.